Hello and welcome. In this video, we will learn how to draw a random sample in Microsoft Excel using simple random sampling and systematic sampling. I will draw a sample both by using formulas and then using built-in sampling function in Excel. I am Dr. Farhad Zulfikar. Let's get right into it. Now let's open an Excel file and see how it works. Here I have an Excel file with a list of names, 200 names to be exact. I want to draw a sample of 10. So let's draw it first through random numbers and then through automatic sample using an Excel function. So first I will draw a random number, rand between. I use this option, random number between 1 and 200. As I need a sample of 10, so I'll drag it to 10 numbers. Note that each time I perform any change in this Excel sheet, these numbers will change. So I will copy these numbers and paste as values. So these numbers are my sample size. I can do the same thing through automatic way. Go to data, data analysis, search for sampling here, press OK. We need an input range, so I'll select all this column. As I also selected the label, so I will check this box and I want a random sample of size 10 and I want the output to be in the same sheet. So I'll go up and select the particular column where I want my data to be. Here I'll press OK and here I get a sample size of exactly 10 numbers. If you want a systematic sample, I have the same population here. My population size is 200 and the required sample is 10. So I need two things for a systematic sample: an interval, which is population divided by the required sample size. This gives me an interval of 20. The first starting point is generated through a rand between function, this command, random number between 1 and 200. Again, it will change every time I perform any change here. So I'll manually write this 159. So my starting point is 159 and my next sample will be this number plus the interval here, which is 20. I can drag it down all the way to the needed 10 samples. You will note that our maximum number is 200. So we need to start over 199 and after that we have one sample. So the next starting point will be from 0 till 19. So 19 plus 1 will be the interval which we need. So instead of 219, we'll have 19 as our next point and plus 20 automatically it goes. So this is our sample through systematic sampling. We can do it again automatically through this data analysis function. Sampling, okay. I need to select the input range, which is the same first column. Then again, we have label. We will select periodic here, so the interval is the same 20 and I want my output to be in this particular column. As soon as I press OK, I will get a sample size of 10 right here. You will notice that it gives a particular type of numbers. So if there is any systematic pattern in your data, then systematic sampling will not be that appropriate. So I suggest when selecting through systematic sampling, use this formula-based sample. Thank you very much for your time. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and also press the bell icon for more videos like these.